Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to Bioshock 2, where we're trying to delve a bit deeper into the lore and the story of this game. And actually a bit more about Fontaine Futuristics in this episode, because fired, yes, that's Gil Alexander's bolt that can only write that apparently, because right here we're at the office of Frank Fontaine, and it kind of looks familiar if you've seen or played the previous game. But another thing, Fontaine Futuristic isn't what it seems it appears to be, because there's a lot more hidden in this area, aside from very interesting stuff in the water over there. Solid, ooh, that was very interesting ammo. That was really, really good. But yeah, there's a lot of experiments that are being done in this laboratory, in this facility. And before that, we're gonna have to deal with whatever is inside of the office. And I think, by the sounds of it, it's one of the Alpha series. Hello! You like bees? You're a bees. I think, oh, increased damage. There we go. Let's go with the shotgun while he's distracted by the bot. And that just takes care of him easily. Well, the easiest way, because he's kind of a mechanical enemy, so if you use heavy rivets or armor-piercing rounds, that will work very, very well as well. But the bees and the turret combined were enough to keep him distracted for me to just shotgun him in the face. So, the office of Frank Fontaine. If you remember, his apartment from the previous game had a similar layout. So you had the polar bear in the middle over there, and then two sides for this entire area. Horror. So that is, if I'm not mistaken, that's supposed to be a picture of Fontaine's wife at the time, and then of course himself, whore and liar. So Fontaine and his wife were a liar and a whore, according to the splices, of course, that worked for Andrew Ryan. But there's a lot of things hidden in this office, because if I'm not mistaken, maybe I am mistaken, because I know there's a way to... Oh, wait. Is it that thing? Yeah, okay, so the conspicuous boar mount. You can turn that thing, and then it opens this curtain on the left here, with a lot of safes and a very interesting audio diary. Goodbye to Fontaine.
Every time Ryan turns up the heat, I know I'm a little bit closer to beating him at his own game. But now the game's changing. Ryan's boys are coming in heavy, looking to knock down my door and take what's mine. Like this is the first time I had to dodge a bullet. They're coming to my house expecting a show, but they're gonna get a disappearing act. Say goodbye to Fontaine and hello to Atlas.
So there we go. The reason why those voices don't sound all that right is because there's actually a different voice actor for Fontaine and Atlas, so they're not really the same voice actor, so you can't really smoothly transition from one voice to the other. But these saves are actually really well stocked with health kits, Eve hypos, and a variety of every kind of ammo you would want. And with Arms Race still equipped, that actually stocked us up really, really good. But behind this panel is our next signal relay. Goodbye. And I think Gil Alexander is going to have something to say about that, or not. Apparently not. Weird. Thought he said something after every destroyed signal relay. And maybe it's because we have all those traps available over there. I don't think there's anything else in this office, no. So that compartment is completely hidden, so you might have missed that in your playthrough. But aside from that, I don't think there's anything of interest over here. And then, of course, the last area we need to go to, the arrow points us in that direction.
Each new tyrant ventured here in search of conquest, Delta. Fontaine, Ryan. And now you. But every aspiring Caesar must learn to fear the knives of his fellows. Ask yourself, what does Sinclair stand to gain in guiding you here?
Yes, well, he kind of explained that a lot already, because he wants to sell everything of value in this place, the technology and everything, the patents towards that. And this is the marketing administration, and as you can see, kind of looks a bit weird. Because this is probably one of the most freaky areas in the game. So these guys are all, well, bound to their seats and impaled. So the administration, it's kind of implied that the administration of Fontaine Futuristics was murdered by Andrew Ryan, the splicers of Andrew Ryan, when they also defiled Frank Fontaine's office and they tried to kill him. But yeah, marketing department. And there's a lot of interesting stuff in here. There we go. Because those guys are, of course, not really dead. There we go. Let's just use the bees. And have to see where the... Oh, hi. There we go. That's one. I do want to take a picture of... I'm almost dead, it appears. God damn it. Select the right thing for one second. Getting really, really annoying that selection doesn't go all as planned. Yeah, bye. Because I think we're almost done with the research into Houdini splicers, if I'm not mistaken. Eve Hypo, no, but the health kit I'm gonna take. So yeah, a lot of people were killed here during the Andrew Ryan raid. Not rate. Rate is something different. Then we have this lovely object. This is the unstable teleport plasmid. And when you touch it, well, it teleports to, well, 20 centimeters to the right. If you touch it again, it teleports again. So kind of the same effect as the Houdini splicers have. I'm just gonna take all that money, thank you very much. And yeah, it kind of alludes to the fact that there might have been a teleport plasmid once in this game, but it's, well, we're not done with it yet, but it's really a really cool addition what they did with it eventually. I'm not gonna spoil too much about that because it's really, really cool. So there we go, we can see outside again, and that is actually very interesting because they're... It's one of the first time we can actually see how bad Rapture is. Well, how bad the state of Rapture is right now. So even some of the buildings have actually completely collapsed and have been destroyed. So yeah, interesting indeed. Don't really see the most important part of Fontaine Futuristics, but I'm not going to tell you any more about that just yet. So let's go back outside, and over there is the teleport plasmid again. Just gonna check the rest of the offices really quickly. Because there might be something in here. And I still hear another camera, so... Yeah, let's take the remote hack dart. Take a picture of the... Ooh, what's that? Is that the last one? Yeah, okay, it is the last one. You go. I have to let you go, okay? I think the camera is on the... Oh, what the... Oh yeah, shit. That's right, this thing electrocutes the floor. Source of volunteers.
Anyone in the plasmid business ultimately requires the use of human test subjects. It's our dirty little secret. And to be frank, Rapture doesn't really want to know, provided the end product is sound. Volunteers were scarce, even as the economy buckled. A man named...
Without an infraction, just earned you another slap on the nose, boy!
So I'm actually gonna take advantage of the problem here. I'm gonna put myself over here in a corner, and I'm gonna just get electrocuted by the security system over here. And otherwise I'm just gonna shock the water myself if anything comes to it. Can they actually see me? He can kind of see me. I can't shoot him from over here, but... Just gonna electrocute it just one more time, just in case. And then I'm just gonna... Yeah, simple rivet will do this. There we go. Could actually hack that thing as well to just take care of the relay, but... There we go.
Benefits
rescinded. And there goes the security bolt. So, but Alexander the Great kind of blocked off what his, what he himself was saying in the audio diary, so let's re-listen to that.
Anyone in the plasmid business ultimately requires the use of human test subjects. It's our dirty little secret. And to be frank, Rapture doesn't really want to know, provided the end product is sound. Volunteers were scarce, even as the economy buckled. A man named Sinclair approached us with a seemingly limitless supply. He rented them to us, bound and sedated. No questions asked.
So volunteers came from Sinclair, and Sinclair, we know he was also responsible for sending Sophia Lamb to prison, so we kind of can assume, and because Alexander the Great also said as much, that most of the volunteers for the Alpha series and the plasmid lines were actually criminals. Or not even criminals, just people that were sent to prison, not necessarily criminals in this case, as we can clearly see from ourselves. Hello? I think there's people coming in, but doesn't look like they want to enter the building proper, so let's go introduce ourselves. Hello? Ow! He even damaged me with this fire, that was actually really smart. I'm on fire, so I'm gonna run into you. So, we still have that teleport plasmid over here, so let's touch it again. And it disappears again. Not really sure where it went. Where did it go? Where would it have gone? Because, yeah, it seems to have disappeared. Hello? And there we go. And that's the next position, and a Houdini Spicer comes to, okay. What are you doing? Yeah, bye. You want to take care of that Houdini splicer? No? Let's just touch the plasmid again. There it goes. And I kind of have to remember where it spawns next, because I think it's downstairs on the left. Is it over there? Yeah, yeah. I knew it. Yes, my memory serves me right. And touch it again. And it's gone again. And then there's a Houdini splicer over there. Probably gonna teleport. Oh, gold. Boom! Acquired tonic natural camouflage. There it is again, because we've kind of used that a bit in the previous game, but not really that much. But need some peace and quiet. Splice in natural camouflage, stop moving, and just fade away. Remember, not seeing is believing. So I'm not going to use that just yet, but I am going to use that in the future, because I want to try something once we head to the next area, and I'm hoping that will be very cool. So, next position of the unstable teleport plasmid, right here. And now something happens, because it starts floating, and we're starting to freak out, because now we just teleported. Hello, sir. Hello. Because he's freaking out because of the plasmid. And then we teleport again, right next to that lovely woman. We rescued her already. And then this guy's starting to panic because the plasmid is following him. And now we're outside. Luckily, we're in a suit. Because, yeah. And then this. This. I don't know what this is. Never really had an explanation for this. Because this is some kind of very dark, very large open area. It kind of looks like the area that we were in Fort Frolic, that had all the spider splices, the plaster spider splices. But these guys are just stone statues this time, and they all are carrying a camera. And then there's a few worshipping this tonic plasma thing, but I don't know how this fits into the story somehow. Because this is the only way to actually enter this area. You can't attack, you can't do anything over here. Aside from walk around. And then just take... I can't even take the Eve High Boost because I'm out. And I can't reload either, so... Vending Expert 2, and it's a really bad tonic. I'm not even going to use this. But the way this is set up is just so creepy. So, Fending Expert 2, watch your dollars go even further with Fending Expert 2. Enjoy rock-bottom prices from all of Rapture's vending machines. Nope, thank you. And then the cameras go off. And I'm back at the entrance of Fontaine Futuristic, so an area where we haven't been to in two episodes. So, yeah, I really don't have an explanation for that. Probably something to do with the deaths over here, that somehow the ghost or something had their revenge, but... Yeah, Sophia, shut the fuck up. I'm actually wondering if there are more big daddies in this area. Yeah, there should be two more, but I haven't seen any just yet. But I think the area is bigger than this, so that we can actually find more big daddies, but they just don't spawn anymore in this area. Let's check this one out. So let's head back to the front and use our audio thingy-majiggy. And then we can get to that pyro to the people station as well, which is really, really nice. So, play password.
Agnes Day.
Agnes Day. Still haven't checked out what that actually meant. Might have to research that in a minute. But yeah, the security office. Really, really nice. So a few supplies if you want to. I'm actually gonna just reload and reuse my health as well to fill that up completely. And then we have, oh, hello? Hello, Gil?
Hello again. I must assume by now that you're willing to help end my life. In exchange, I have prepared a friendly security escort for you. Now, there's a switch in here which will allow you access to the real laboratories where what's left of me awaits you. Please, use it.
Thank you, Gil. So access to the real laboratory, because what we've been seeing for now was actually a front for what's really happening underneath this place. So we can't actually carry anything anymore. So let's upgrade our weapons. Launcher damage immunity would be nice. I think I'm gonna go for the drill reflector upgrade. So now, as long as we're drilling the We're spinning the drill, we can actually deflect incoming projectiles that are coming, of course, from in front of us. So, plasmid laboratory access, activate. So, that did everything we wanted it to do. And there's now the access over there on the left, but just want to check, because there's a lot of splicers here for some reason. Hello? Let's just dump him in the face. Thank you very much. And I think, yeah, we've done everything in this area, right? So, yeah, just wondering if I missed anything, but I don't think I did. There's a few more splicers around, but every area has been explored, so... Let's go down and just hit this guy in the head. That actually does quite a bit of damage. Didn't really expect that for a melee hit. Oh, hi! I'm just gonna use... the shotgun, because that's really good against the Alpha series. And now we're just gonna... Hi! Blaster in the face. Thank you very much. So let's go over here. And that should lead us out of here. And into something... Well, honestly, something way, way worse. Oh, hello? For fuck's sake. Oh, hi! Where are you going? So he's just gonna run away again. Come on, stop! What the hell is going on? Jesus Christ, dude. What? Oh, I actually completed with Houdini splices, apparently, so no need for that. Let's just get my spear back and continue on. So we're starting to see more signs of actual, well, Big Daddy construction, although this is probably just here because of the... Yeah, we're gonna have to go outside to reach the real laboratory. Hello, bot. So, again, not really sure why this bot is following me, because I think it actually disappears once I go outside. But, a abort the experiment.
I was to be Sophia Lamb's greatest achievement. A living composite of all Rapture's genius in the body of a single man, unfettered by self-interest. Now, I am nothing more to her than a failed experiment. My scores on tests of intelligence and moral reasoning are still noteworthy, but declining sharply. She has abandoned me, and I do not have long before psychosis takes me.
Abort the experiment. So Gil Alexander performed an experiment on himself that completely went wrong and turned him into the madman that he is now. We also have a few other hints about what happened, because his audio recordings already mentioned what was left of him. So he must have physically changed as well. But I'm guessing we're about to find out, right? Because we're going to head deeper inside of the facility. So let's head outside and... Do I need to... Hello? Cycle! There we go. Kind of was confused because the marker said we were done there. So I'm hoping the Big Daddy count just goes, the Little Sister count just continues, because that was kind of weird that I didn't have any other Big Daddy spawns. Because there were enough corpses, if I remember correctly, so that would suck if I missed a few corpses because of that. But I think I can still go back. So there we go, the back of Fontaine Futuristics. Very, very lovely building. Yeah, very lovely building. But we're gonna leave that for something completely different. Gonna have to take a look around though, because there might be atom slugs nearby. I'm just gonna start moonwalking around a bit. And let's see. We have the joint Welcome to Rapture music again. And a dead Alpha Seer. It's not so very interesting in regards to their design. They have been outside for a very long time, so that's because all the Alpha Seers have those carbuncles on their bodies. And inside it looks like a red mess. So not really sure how they look on the inside, because I've seen a few of the designs they started out with, and let me tell you, they don't look pretty. Might actually include a few of these in the recording here, because they look hideous. Hideous. Are these stairs going anywhere? Can't really remember. I remember taking these, but I think there's just... Is there an atom slug around here? Yeah, there we go. Thank you very much, 10 atom. Actually never spent the atom I got from the little sister, so let's jump. Let's take a shortcut. Floating down the stairs. There we go. Not sure if that's how physics work, but never mind. As I can kind of choose my direction. Doesn't look like Delta's swimming anywhere.
As I recall from my time doing business with the owners, that oxyfill station out there is just a front for a kind of hidden passage leading down below. If Lamb's hiding Eleanor from you, that's where she'll be.
So this oxyfill station, so it's not drill fuel, it's oxygen, is actually a hidden front for the secret laboratory. So let's just go further in this area. Because this is actually the laboratory, I'm sorry. The place where Eleanor is hidden is underneath that oxy station. But right now we need to go in here. And I'm not sure if there's going to be a load screen here or not. Doesn't look like it. No, it's not. Although it's pretty dark at the moment. Because, yeah, now we're starting to come into the horror aspect of Bioshock 2. So let's go inside and enable our flashlight. Because, yeah, things have taken a turn for the worse. So there are these very weird plants around here, which kind of work like enrage, so hypnotize. So we can actually use those. Hypnotic bullet. Heat-seeking rockets, that doesn't bode well. And then let's enter the laboratory itself.
I'm afraid the lights in here sting my eyes terribly now. Until you arrive to deal with me, they will remain off. Please, locate the breakers and flip them, and then return here to restore power.
The light stings my eyes, and we need to turn on the light, because, yeah. We're not gonna be able to do much without light in this place. So let's take a look around, shall we? I'm not gonna hack anything just yet, just because, well, I have a plan for everything here. And let's just take a look around. I know where the breakers are, but I just wanna take a look around, because this area is so creepy. So there's one of the breakers. So activate that. One out of two. Can't take any more of the solid slugs, so might actually switch over to that. And then we have this big cage over here. This big glass cage. And yeah, we can't see inside there just yet, so there's a gallery's garden here, but I can actually check this out. Well then, let's not waste any more time. Incinerate tree? Is telekinesis tree already available? I don't think that becomes available, no. So I'm gonna have to wait for that. I could go with electrobolt tree, so here we go. Now every attack causes chain lightning. Press and hold L2 to charge to release a continuous electrical storm. So yes, indeed, we're gonna turn into Darth Sidious.
Every bolt hits more than one foe. Charge up to blast them with a deadly storm.
Because now we can just blast electricity out of our wrists as long as we want to. Well, as long as the Eve allows for it, of course. Could go for the health and the Eve upgrade. Definitely gonna go for the Eve upgrade. So I'm just gonna keep that. Now I'm quickly gonna check. Okay, so yeah, so there's still one little sister that we saved. So that's really, really good. And now I think the other breaker is on this side. So those plants have taken over pretty much everything. Heavy rivets, thank you very much. And then let's switch this on. That turns on the electricity. So now we need to activate the power completely back on top, but solving for X.
Sophia believes the perfect human altruist is just a formula, waiting on us to solve for X. Intelligence and consciousness are not the same, she argued. Awareness of self naturally becomes obsession with it. So, if we could suppress my sense of self, but imbue me with the cognitive capacity to serve the common welfare, we could thereby generate the first utopian. And then, Sophia said, at long last, utopia would follow.
So there we go. Sophia already mentioned that she couldn't create utopia, that utopia couldn't precede the utopian. So what Gil Alexander was saying was actually not what Sophia wanted, because he tried to make himself the utopian before utopia was even here. And now, please keep your eyes peeled, because this is amazing.
Sophia and I knew that to create the first true utopian would come at a high cost, my friend. We needed someone to be host to all that Adam, Rapture's finest minds. A willing subject, that is to say, myself.
Turn on the lights, please. Have you seen that enormous bulbous monster inside of the tank?
That was indeed me. I fear the fate of Eleanor Lamb will be less physical, but no less grotesque. This tank for deep sea life is the ideal way to dispose of me. But first, you must retrieve enough Adam-infused plant life to lure me out. The slugs feed on the stuff, and it's all I seem to want now. I have left a sample here, so you know what to look for.
So this is the Adam-infused plant we need to collect.
I see you out there, Delta. You want to be top man? You want to sit in the big chair? Well, come and take it.
And that we will. What the fuck was that? Goodbye. Just need to be careful, because I'm, of course... There we go, that's one down. Now we need to take care of the other guy, because he's throwing grenades at us, I think. There we go. Electrical storm. Why stick with a boring routine when discouraging pesky foes? Use this tonic for a scorching, shocking, or chilling surprise. You emit a random burst of fire, ice, or electricity when struck by melee attacks, damaging all around you. I'm gonna keep that in the bank as well. So, stopped him in his tracks, and now we're just gonna go for shotgun. Oh, wait for that. Fire at me, buddy. Goodbye. Do that again. Oh, I couldn't quite get that. Goodbye, buddy. Goodbye, good sir. Can I get your grenade
launcher,
please? Well,
listen, son. Those override keys you've been hunting are genetically encoded. And to get to Eleanor, you're gonna need one from Alex the Great in there. First things first, we gotta pin him down, find those plants he mentioned, and lure him back out.
So again, Sinclair being pretty obvious, we need to track down those plants to lure him back out and then just completely destroy his ass. So sometimes he pauses, so you can see something moving in there. But yeah, the first thing we saw was probably the only thing we're gonna see for a while now, because he just left and we need to get those plants to lure him back out. So that's our next objective, but before that I'm gonna take a little break, and for the next episode, oh, you know what, I'm gonna just listen to this first. Gil's place in the plan.
Dr. Alexander has agreed to accept both measures of the new Utopian project. He will become a kind of genetic chimera, host to all the minds of Rapture, accessing their talents and memories via the Adam we have gathered. And deriving in part from Project WYK, I have developed a new set of behavioral constraints. Dr. Alexander will live to promote the common good. His love and loyalty shall be spread evenly across the entire human race. For me, that is discipline at great personal cost. For him, at last, it will be instinct.
But that instinct turned very, very animalistic. So we already knew that the plan was to inject all the Adam into a single human being. And before they wanted to do that with Eleanor, they did that with Gil Alexander. But because his body wasn't really prepared for that, it started to grow exponentially, as we've seen in the splices on a smaller scale. So especially the brute splices, but that just turned out horrifying for Gil Alexander himself. And the effect you wanted to reach with adding the Would You Kindly project from the previous game didn't turn out as she wanted either. So yeah, very, very sad. But with that discussed, we're gonna take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really, really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So next up, we're gonna try and kill Gil Alexander, but that will have to be until next time. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video series. Goodbye!